kuchiza kwanguha etakaba besa tahojeyi.
Some MPs are made to attend burials at the invitation of the electors, yet they are still trying to carry out their legislative duties for their constituencies.
The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, said because most members of Parliament are currently under pressure to attend burials, weddings and fundraising functions, they are failing to legislate.
Don't start pressurizing your MPs to come to villages every week at burials or parties by supporting their rivals. This is because once those rivals also win, the same strategies will be used against them because they have not performed well.
The 2 days Parliament outreach has attracted the region's MPs, district chairpersons, chief administrative officers and RDCs among others to discuss issues affecting Rwenzori and Toro. Tayewa says leaders should start working together to enhance the development of the region.
Oversight, legislative and representative roles of honorable members of parliament on the one hand and local councillors on the other, and the overall objective of course is to ensure enhanced scrutiny and quality of legislation at all levels. We have got new innovations which our honorable councillors should know. The first innovation is that the Parliament of Uganda is by law now mandated to mentor and even orient local government councils.
Richard Rabuhinga, the Kabarole district chairperson, who also doubles as the president of Uganda Local Government Association, said some laws have crippled development in local governments. Rabuhinga says many projects at the local government level have remained unfinished because they lack powers to contract contractors to work on them.
The Public Finance and Management Act, right honorable, which takes part of the powers of local governments to the center. The local governments in this country, the districts and the cities, are now left as mere votes, whereby we are required to collect our local revenue, surrender it to the Ministry of Finance, and wait until they are ready to send it back to us. But when we are waiting, the cities are choking on garbage, services cannot be delivered, councillors cannot be paid their emoluments, because of this very unfriendly act.
The Uganda Local Government Association president instead recommends that money allocated to different projects should be put to use rather than taking it back to the treasury.
If the monies are committed, contracts are signed, the projects are all going, we pray that these monies be reinvested, they are not taken for voting. Now the money about 4.5 million per district will appear in May, but in June it will be swept away again. But this one undermines our manifest as NRA. Because in the year 2021, we made a social contract with the people of Uganda. We told them we are going to build schools, civil secondary schools.
Report compiled by Jonan Tusingwire for the news.